Kitty cats.
We're cute.
But I'm cuter.
Meow.
Clowning around with Boris. One day, the kittens were talking about what they wanted to be when they grew up.
When I grow up, I'm going to be a sea captain.
And I'll be a concert pianist.
And I'll be a great scientist.
And I want to be a clown.
Boris, do you really want to be a clown? You're kind, but not so funny.
Well, clowns aren't funny people in real life. They're funny with their bodies, when they perform.
But you never perform, Boris.
You're right. Which means I better start. I'll come up with a funny routine and perform it for everyone. Everyone will laugh a lot.
So awesome! Meow, 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 meow.
But at home, the kittens realized that they were worried about Boris.
But what if his routine turns out not to be funny? Boris will be so sad if he does a show and no one laughs.
What if we sneak and tickle every kitten's paws? Then they're sure to laugh.
Something's funny, everyone laughs at the same time.
We could put this in the audience and play a laugh track on it.
It would be really strange to hear laughter, but not see anybody laughing.
Or you three could help Boris come up with his clown show. Friends are supposed to help one another.
The kittens went to help Boris with his routine.
Oh, thanks a lot for coming. My costume is pretty ready, but I still haven't thought up a funny routine.
We can help you with that.
Everyone usually laughs when someone falls down.
Look, like this. You just drop the banana peel and then you slip on it and fall on your bottom. Go on, you got this. Looks like comedy wipeouts aren't your thing either.
Everybody laughs when they hear a funny song, so just sing something hilarious.
La la la, la la la.
Funny songs really need to have funny words.
But I don't know any really funny songs.
Oh, here's something funny to do. Comedy gold, pie in the face, and all you have to do is stand still while I do the rest. You ready?
No. Well, that was a total waste of a delicious cake.
Yeah, and for nothing, because it wasn't even funny.
This is all my fault. I'm not funny at all. I won't ever be a real clown.
Boris, you're really funny. That's hilarious.
Am I? I wasn't trying to be funny. It somehow just happened by itself.
You know what? I think you really do have the talent to be a real clown.
I have a really good idea.
The kittens came up with a clown routine to showcase Boris's natural talent. And that's how the kitty cats realized that a talent may not always be easy to see. Sometimes it can even be discovered by accident. Off to the races. One day, the kittens brought remote-controlled cars to the playground.
Now car number one speeds ahead of the pack, rounding all obstacles.
Hey, I think we should build our own racetrack on the playground.
So we can have a race?
so awesome! Me-wow!
But I want to be in the race as well!
Do you even know how to drive these cars?
Well, no, but I'd really like to learn. May I?
Okay, fine.
This drives the car forward, and this button makes it go backward. Finally, you steer it by turning this little wheel.
It seems simple enough. Not that way! No, stop! Let me try to back up. Okay, I'm starting to get the hang of it.
Which way are you going? Go backwards! Reverse! Well, that's about enough of that. Everybody knows that girls aren't any good at driving.
They just aren't quick enough.
But girls are really good at pushing strollers, so that's something.
Here, let's put a really sharp turn.
And then we can put a ramp here.
I'm gonna prove to them that girls are every bit as good at driving cars as boys are.
Candy found the remote control that operates her robo-fish.
Excellent. Now I just need a little practice. Thank you, Daddy. I think these are Dad's. Not that way. Wait, I said? Just stop! The flood! It looks like boys really are better at driving than girls, Mom.
What? Boys? That's not true at all. Driving fast doesn't mean driving well. When I drive home from the supermarket, I try to avoid every pothole and bump and turn very gently because I don't want to spill my groceries everywhere.
I've got a really good idea!
Candy drove the RoboFish very carefully to keep her favorite doll safe.
All set for the race?
Yeah.
What is that thing? A sardine mobile?
Candy the sardine driver.
Come on, Candy. Hurry up. Flap your fins faster.
Drivers, start your engines. Go!
Swam across the line first.
It's first, middle, and last.
Then Candy wins and we all lose.
It looks like girls can become good drivers after all.
And since I was victorious, you boys have to push my doll carriage. Just do it carefully, please.
Turns out not only being fast, but also being careful can help win the race, no matter how big or small. Playing in the dark. One night, Mommy and Daddy went out to dinner and left the kittens at home with Grandma.
Grandma, will you play with us, please?
I have to finish making your dinner before I can play, darlings. But you three just go ahead and I'll join in when I'm finished.
So awesome! Me-wow, 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 me-wow!
Whoa! The lights went out.
Did I clap too hard?
Cookie Pudding, what happened? I'm afraid of the dark.
Why? What's there to be afraid of?
But you were just blindfolded when we were playing, and that's the same thing as being in the dark.
But wearing a blindfold isn't nearly as dark as real darkness.
Kittens, where are you?
Grandma!
It looks like every single light in the house is out, but everything's going to be all right. We need to head down to the cellar to find some flashlights.
But it's even darker down there. Maybe we can wait up here for the lights to come back on?
But what if they stay off for a long time? We'll be fine down there, kittens, because we'll all be together the whole time.
Well, all right.
Going down the steps, dears. Goodness, what's the matter, Candy?
I'm frightened. It's even darker down there, you know.
I'm not even a bit scared, and I'll tell you why. Because darkness is our friend. There are many beautiful things that we never see without it, like the lovely glimmer of this candlelight and the twinkling stars. These wonderful things can only be seen in the dark.
The stars aren't up there. Oh, wow!
Not to mention, there's a great deal of fun to be had when you're playing in the dark, especially if you can get your paws on a flashlight. Come and look at this, Candy. Look, it's a duck. Quack, 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 quack.
And this is a mountain.
Look, Cookie Mobile.
Beep, beep.
Whoa, I just got very hungry.
Yeah, I'm starving!
Goodness, kittens, I'm afraid I forgot to finish dinner in all the confusion. Let's try to root out something to eat down here. Something which doesn't need any cooking.
I already found something awesome. Cookies.
And I see apples over here.
I've got carrots.
Dinner is served.
Huh?
Oh, and look, the lights are back on as well.
Oh, no.
But we were having all that fun in the dark.
And it wasn't really scary at all.
Huh.
Hey, I just had a really good idea. See, now we can play in the dark again. All we want.
So awesome! Me-wow, 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 me-wow!
Goodness, kittens, what's going on in here? Has the electricity gone out?
Yeah!
Oh!
It did go out, but it's on again. We just have the lights out because the dark is fun.
Why, Candy, you're not afraid of the dark anymore? That's just wonderful. Well done.
Come over here, everyone, and enjoy our shadow show.
And that's how Candy learned that darkness is really nothing to be afraid of. And playing in the dark can be a lot of fun. The restaurant. One day, Mommy and Daddy took the kittens to a restaurant to celebrate their wedding anniversary.
Good evening.
Good evening.
We're celebrating with our favorite meal tonight.
This place has got the best pumpkin pie in the entire town.
So awesome! Me-wow.
Shh! Hush, kittens. You must mind your manners in a restaurant this night.
Oh.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening, sir.
Allow me to escort your family to your table. Here we are.
Wow, it's a picture from your wedding.
You looked really good back then, Mom.
Looked back then?
Mommy and Daddy still look just as good.
We know what we'd like to order. Can you please bring us the specialty of the house, the pumpkin pie?
But of course.
This is
boring, guys. Is this any way to have an anniversary celebration? I expected something really fun. Where are the fireworks and balloons? Why are there no rose petals falling from the ceiling?
And aren't doves supposed to hold up a congratulations banner?
This can't be much fun for our poor parents. Try and figure out how to make this celebration even better.
Well, we can ask the piano player to play a song that our parents love.
We can ask the waiter to light some nice romantic candles when he brings us our pie.
That's a great idea, Cookie. And I know something we can use instead of rose petals. Pink napkin pieces.
Awesome. Operation Celebration begins now.
Mommy? Daddy? May we go to the restroom to wash our paws?
Mm-hmm. You may, kittens. Just be careful.
The kittens tried their very best to help their parents enjoy their special night. Pudding made arrangements with the pianist. As did Cookie with the waiter. And Candy collected napkins.
I figured out how to turn off the light. The candles will look better in the dark.
Now we just need to wait until they bring our pumpkin pie out.
Look, it's coming now. All right, it's time.
I'm very sorry.
Mr. Waiter Cat, you were supposed to light the candles when you brought our pie out.
But that wasn't your pie, little ones. It was for that gentle cat there. Whew. Here comes yours now.
Oh, no. We wanted to make this the perfect celebration, but we just ruined everything.
We can see that you tried hard, kittens. It means a lot to us.
However, it's better if we started heading home. I'm very sorry for all this. I'd like you to have our pie as an apology.
Oh, no worries. But you have something big to celebrate, don't you? So please, take it home with you.
I have a really good idea. Welcome to Le Fantastic Kitty Cat Restaurant.
Might I suggest that you order the specialty of the house?
Pumpkin pie. Enjoy.
Happy anniversary, my dear wonderful wife.
Happy anniversary, darling.
Congratulations! Me wow, me wow, me wow, me wow.
The kitty cats made a lovely celebration, just like in a proper restaurant. It was wonderfully festive and very touching for their mommy and daddy. Very early one morning, Daddy tiptoed through the house to sneak out the front door.
Daddy!
Where are you going so early?
It's Mommy's birthday today, Daddy.
Did you forget?
I would never, ever forget Mommy's birthday, you know. But I left her present back at my office at work. I just need to slip out and pick up the present, then we can all wish her happy birthday. Wait for me, okay?
So awesome!
Shh! Don't wake up Mommy.
Meow, 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 meow.
The kitty cats were giving Mommy a beautiful drawing they made.
It's the prettiest picture ever.
What do you think Daddy's birthday present for Mommy is?
Well, he said he left a present at his office, and his office is in the middle of a candy factory. I'm guessing it's a yummy cake of some sort.
But Daddy brings cake home from work every weekend. And a birthday present is supposed to be special, Pudding.
But you know, a cake can be awesome and special. For instance, you could put a letter inside it.
What if Mommy accidentally ate the letter, though?
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Oh. You could also hide some fireworks inside a cake so they could fly up and go kaboom!
But what if it goes wrong and doesn't fly up?
Huh?
something really special to go with the cake. Something Mommy's really fond of.
Mommy's fond of sports.
And Mommy's fond of pink clothes.
And Mommy thinks flowers are the best. Hey, let's pick a bouquet of pretty flowers. Then Daddy can give them to her as a present.
But the kitty cats had forgotten that Mommy's birthday was in the autumn. Still, they didn't give up. They looked everywhere for flowers. They looked and looked. But pretty flowers just don't grow in the autumn.
No flowers. What do we do now?
Daddy can't just give Mommy a cake and nothing else.
Oh, I think I have a really good idea. What if we made a bouquet from different fallen leaves? Because they're really colorful and pretty, aren't they?
The kitty cats couldn't wait for Mommy to see the beautiful autumn bouquet.
Good morning, everyone.
Morning! Happy birthday! Nothing behind our backs!
We're waiting to give you your presents until Daddy gets back, all right?
Daddy gets back? Where did he go?
Where's the birthday girl? I have her present right here.
Hey, guys, that's not a cake box.
It's a beautiful pink tracksuit. And pretty shoes as well.
It's all the things you're fond of in one gift. Sports, clothes that are pink colored, and pretty flowers.
Oh, darling, thank you so very much.
What a perfect present for Mommy.
Guess we don't need this bouquet anymore then.
We still need it, Pudding. We'll give it to Mommy with our present.
Love you, Mommy. Happy birthday. Time for your birthday presents.
First, there's this picture that we drew for you.
Then this leaf bouquet.
Oh, thank you, my little sweeties. Look at them. These are the most wonderful presents that I've ever received.
So awesome! Me wow, me wow, me wow, me wow!
Daddy had also brought a yummy cake, of course. And Mommy blew out her candles. But she couldn't think of anything to wish for that she didn't already have.
The harvest!
One day, Mommy and Daddy took the kitty cats to visit Granny in the country.
Granny! Meow!
Oh! Welcome, my little dear ones.
You're gonna play with us all day, like last time, right?
Yeah!
Bye-bye, kitties!
Bye-bye!
Play!
We will be having playtime, but first I have to spend a little time taking care of the crops that are growing in my garden. Just look at all the things I've planted. Apples, carrots, strawberries, flowers. And all of them need to be looked after.
Hey, I've got a great idea. Let's help Granny do her gardening. That way she'll be done with her work sooner and have extra time to play with us.
So awesome! Me wow, me wow, me wow, me wow!
Put your paws up if you're having lots of fun.
Cheer up, kitties. After this, we get to pull all the weeds out of the garden and water all the flowers.
If we do all that, we won't have time to play. Look, maybe we should skip something, like scraping this dirt around.
But digging the soil is very important. We can only plant potatoes in loose soil. Doesn't work any other way. Have to loosen the soil or you might as well plant your potatoes in concrete, which is impossible, by the way.
Then maybe we could skip the part where we pull all the weeds out.
But weeds can mess up the look of the whole flower bed. Imagine if your mommy decided to just stop cutting her hair. Before you know it, her hair would completely take over. Ha!
My darling, huh?
Oh!
Oh! Oh! No! Oh.
But what if we, wait until next time it rains instead of watering everything now?
But plants need water every single day, just like us. What if your daddy decided he'd wait for it to rain before he took his next shower, huh?
Yay! All clean.
Gosh, looks like plants really count on us to help them live their lives.
We have to take care of the plants. It's the right thing to do. I'm going to march right into that flower bed and get rid of all the weeds.
And me and Pudding will take care of the soil.
Oh. It's kitten made rainstorm time. Would you like a nice drink, Mr. Apple Tree?
The carrots are taking a shower.
Now your leaves are so clean, strawberries.
This will help all the flower buds to open up.
The kitty cats got so involved in helping with the garden, they forgot all about playtime. Almost.
Phew!
You're such good helpers.
Well, now that the garden work's all done, is it playtime?
Sure, yeah. Why don't we play the harvest game?
Is it a really fun game?
It's tons of fun, and it's helpful as well.
Granny and the kitty cats had a great time collecting all the crops and washing them with cool, clean water.
And now it's time to taste all that we gathered.
That sounds great.
We could really use a break from the game.
Oh, I love strawberries so much.
It's all because of your hard work. Thank you. You're the world's best brand kittens.
So awesome. Me wow, me wow, me wow, me wow.
Well, you must have played really hard all day to get this tired.
Yes, I don't think any bedtime stories will be needed tonight.
Bring them back anytime and maybe stay yourself. There's a few games I'd love to see you playing.
Oh, yeah, like that game you taught me, Paint the Barn. And what was that other one, Chopping Firewood?
I've got a great idea for a new game. Who will fall asleep first?
Oh, I win.
The kitty cats had gathered a delicious harvest and had an absolutely wonderful day.
Daddy Daycare.
One day, Mommy was getting ready to go and visit her friend.
Daddy will be taking over for me today. So try to be good, all right? Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. What exactly does that mean? Dad taking over from Mom? Will he put on a pink dress and grow his hair all fluffy and curly?
Huh? Oh. Hey! Oh! Ow! Ow! Hey! Oh! Ow! No! No! No!
Or will he try to take all of Mommy's fitness classes at the gym?
None of that. What it means is that instead of Mommy taking care of us, it'll be Daddy.
So awesome! Me wow, me wow, me wow, me wow!
Daddy,
Daddy!
Wake up!
Hey!
You're Mommy, Daddy, all day long!
Yeah, all right. Come with Mommy, Daddy.
Daddy made the kitty cats their favorite eclairs.
That's so good. It's so much better than porridge.
It's nice when Daddy fills it for Mommy.
Uh-huh. And now let's watch TV for a while. Oh.
As we enter the 38th hour of the Snow Geese Migration live stream.
Dad, don't you have some other things to do?
Wait, what?
If you're really supposed to be doing what Mommy does, then you should make lunch.
And wash all the clothes.
And then vacuum the entire house.
Does Mommy really do all that? Oh, wow. Okay, then.
The kitty cats turned on their favorite pirate show, while Daddy made pizza for lunch instead of Mommy, and put all the dirty laundry in the washing machine, and tried his best to vacuum the carpets.
Effects are great. You can practically smell smoke for real every time they fire their cannons.
That's not the show. Something's on fire.
Whoa, what's that about?
The laundry room is filling up with bubbles, guys.
Mom?
Wait, it's not Mom, it's Daddy!
Now what?
There's something burning in the kitchen!
And the laundry room's blowing bubbles!
Oh, gosh! Stop! 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 The pizza! Hot! Oh, I'm such a dummy. With the cleaning and the washing, I let the pizza burn.
Mom's chores are a whole lot harder to do than they look, huh?
This will make Mommy so upset.
I have a really good idea. Since the chores are really hard, we should help Daddy with them.
With the kitty cat's help, Daddy managed to get everything done properly.
Mommy, you're back!
Meow, have you been watching TV this entire time?
No, Mom. We helped Daddy clean all the dirty clothes.
And vacuum stuff.
And cook the yummy pie, too.
Super Daddy, you not only kept the kittens entertained, but you did all of the housework?
Oh, well, isn't that what you'd expect from an excellent daddy like me?
It was like Daddy had turned into Mommy.
Everybody had to help me be Mommy.
Well, in that case, I must have turned into your daddy, because he never comes home without something yummy with him.
Strawberries, yay!
So awesome! Me-wow, 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 me-wow!
Daddy and the kitty cats had a fun day pretending to be Mommy. But everyone was so happy when the whole family was together again.
Doctors!
One day, Mom and Dad gave Cookie, Candy, and Pudding a lovely present to play pretend with.
Look what we have for you kittens.
Wow. A doctor said. A thermometer.
Bandages, too.
Doctor's hats.
All the things you'll need to start your very own pretend doctor's office.
So awesome! Me-wow, 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 me-wow!
I'll be the doctor.
No, I want to be the doctor.
Me too.
Well, if all of us are going to be doctors, where are we going to find the patients?
We'll get all of our friends to be patients.
Meow.
We're playing doctors. Are any of you sick?
Oh, yeah. Very.
We make house calls, so we'll be right there. Just let us grab some medicine.
Pass the jelly.
The three kitty cats' first patient was Cupcake.
Now, what seems to be the problem?
Something's sort of wrong with my tail. It just doesn't seem to be quite beautiful enough.
Right, no problem. I can just snip off the old one and sew on a beautiful peacock's tail instead. Simple.
I don't need a whole nother tail. I want a second opinion.
Right. Well, I'm not hearing anything. Shall I wake it up with the hammer?
Stop that! We should just wrap the tail in some bandages.
Okay, as long as they're pretty.
Thanks, doctors. Hope you feel better, madam.
And remember that an apple a day keeps the doctor away.
Now that Cupcake was feeling better, it was time for the three doctors to visit Chase. It certainly was a very windy walk for the kittens.
Now, what seems to be the problem?
Doctor, I think I'm turning into an alien. I can even talk like one.
Aha! You seem to have alien fever.
Then we have just what you need. Eat some of this cosmic better berry jelly. Cures all alien sickness. But looks like I ate all the jelly.
That's all right, because we can just give you a jelly jab instead. You'll feel like an earthling again in no time, unless it turns you into a watermelon or a watering can.
No, I don't want a jelly jab.
Calm down, sir. For being such a good patient, I have this jelly lolly for you. And please be sure to get some rest.
I already feel better.
So Chase was feeling better, too. Our little doctor still had Boris to fix up, so they ran through the rain to their patient.
Achoo! What's bothering you, sir?
Well, the problem is that I get really, really sad on rainy days when the sky is gray.
Maybe we need to curl your whiskers.
No, not my whiskers. It's really kind of my tummy that's hurting.
Oh, sure. Sounds weird. Yep, sounds like you've swallowed a propeller. No, I think it's something even bigger.
That's your tummy pudding because you scarfed up all that jelly.
Huh? Hey, you're right. It's coming from mine.
Your tummy will be good as new after you have some tea and oatcakes. And this book about clowns will cheer you up.
Oh, I've always thought clowns were awesome. I really love their red noses. Goodness, your noses are really red.
Huh? Mommy!
We helped all our patients.
Oh, you're all soaking wet. Kittens, get these wet hats off of your heads, and then it's straight to bed. Drink up this nice lemon tea and then sleep so you won't get sick.
After a lovely night's sleep, the kittens felt great.
Good morning. Did you call a doctor?
I brought you oranges to start your day right.
And I've brought some marbles so we can all play.
And I brought a joke to cheer you up.
And what doctor's office would be complete? Without a speedy ambulance. Oh, I'm an ambulance. What's an ambulance sound like again?
Like this. Meow, 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 meow.
The kittens loved playing doctors, but they loved even more having tons of healthy energy to play with their friends. Mommy's cold. One day, Mommy had caught a cold and had to stay in bed.
Here's your breakfast, kittens. Oh, I'm just gonna go take Mommy some porridge and honey and lemon.
Our poor Mommy. Being ill is no fun at all.
I hope that she gets better really quickly.
Well, we could help her feel better. What if we did something really nice for her?
Oh, yeah. Maybe by cheering her up, we can make the cold go away.
So awesome! Me-wow, 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 me-wow!
I once heard Grandpa say that laughter was the best medicine.
If we really want Mommy to laugh, let's put on a clown show. Mommy will laugh so much, she'll get better right away.
Hot water bottle to keep your toes warm. Here, have some lovely honey with lemon.
Thank you, my darling.
The kitty cats will now perform the funniest show that you've ever seen.
We added laughter medicine.
La, 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 la. Oh, 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 oh.
I don't think Mommy's having much fun.
Kittens, could the three of you please go play in your room? You shouldn't be near Mommy just now. You don't want to catch her cold as well.
Aww. But how are we going to help Mommy if we can't be in the room where she is?
We could play a nice concert for her outside.
Let's do it. I've heard that music can make cats feel better.
The rain had stopped, and the kittens were ready to start their concert.
One, two, three. Let's begin.
Darling, what is that strange noise I hear?
Kittens, could you find a different place to practice, please? Mommy needs peace and quiet to rest.
How are we going to do something nice for Mommy if she can't see us or hear us?
We could bake her a delicious cake and then bring it to her.
Oh,
But we don't know how to bake a cake pudding.
Well, I've watched Daddy do it a bunch of times. The first thing we're gonna need is eggs.
And flour, right?
Kittens, what was that? Oh, me, wow.
We were baking Mommy a cake so she'd feel better.
We want her to feel so good that her cold goes away.
Thank you very much for trying to help Mommy. But for now, we just need to be patient and give her time to get better. And I'll do everything I can to take perfect care of her. It's a real shame I can't make the sun shine for her.
You're right. Mommy's always really happy when it's sunny out.
I have a really good idea.
Darling, look there. The sun is coming out. J-
Just look what a beautiful, bright, shiny sun the kittens have made for me. It's really, really cheering me up. I'm beginning to feel better already.
Mommy started to feel better, and Daddy allowed the kittens to visit her.
Mommy!
How are you feeling now, Mommy?
I'm feeling much better. My lovely kittens really cheered me up. And with all that rest and quiet, I'm really much, much better now.
So awesome! Me-wow, 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 me-wow!
Oh, darling, sounds like you need some bed rest. I think it's my turn to take care of you for a while.
We'll draw a rainbow to make you feel better.
The kittens learned that rest and relaxation is the best cure for a cold and a sprinkle of kitten sunshine. Walkie-talkies. One day, Mommy and Daddy gave the kittens an unusual gift.
Dear kittens, these wonderful gadgets are called walkie-talkies. Over.
Hear you loud and clear. With them, you three can talk to each other from a distance.
So awesome! Me-wow, 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 me-wow!
Attention, this is Candy, and I'm laying on my bed. Over.
Attention, this is Pudding. I'm just here in the kitchen eating an apple. Over.
This is Cookie.
I'm looking out the window. Let's play outside. Over.
I'm coming. Me too.
This is Cookie, and I'm outside. Over.
Yeah, we can see you.
We can hear you too, Cookie.
I guess we really only need these walkie-talkies when we're way far away from each other.
This is Candy here, and I am in Africa. Over.
This is Pudding here, and I'm up in the Arctic Circle. Over.
Hey, can anybody down there hear me? Over. Walkie-talkies don't work when you're in orbit.
Did that lawnmower just pass by on its own?
Never mind that. Let's figure out cool stuff to do with our walkie-talkies.
Well, we could give one to Mommy so she's always able to get in touch with us.
But that's why we have a telephone.
And plus, everyone would hear whatever Mommy was saying.
Careful on the slide, Cookiekins, or you'll tear the backside of your pants like you did last time.
Oh, shush, Mom.
The backside of your pants?
Why does that lawnmower keep running around everywhere by itself?
I don't know. Just like I don't know what to use these walkie-talkies for. It sort of seems like they're not really that useful.
Attention. Huh? This is the police inspector speaking.
Oh.
The city gardener's lawnmower has gone missing. Please report it if you spot it. Over.
Meow. It sounds like Cookie managed to find the police walkie-talkie station.
That's given me a really good idea. Kitty Cat Search Squad here, reporting a break in the case. We've seen the lawnmower. It's running on its own. Over.
Cookie? Candy? Pudding?
Yes, it's us.
Then, by all means, continue the search. Report back with any new information. Over.
Great! Copy that!
Oh, wow! We'll be looking for the lawnmower just like real-life police officers!
I found some lawnmower tracks here. They lead right inside this bush. Over. Oh.
I found some lawnmower tracks around the big old oak tree. Over.
And I see lawnmower tracks pretty much everywhere.
I'm fairly sure I can hear the lawnmower. It's somewhere over there.
Yeah, I see it. It's headed away from us towards home, guys.
Police, come in. The Kitty Cat Search Squad have found the lawnmower in our own backyard.
Roger that. I'm on my way.
Yeah! My beautiful lawnmower! Daddy missed you so much! Come on, stop! Please? Stop, lawnmower! I can't thank you enough for finding it. I don't know what I'd do without it.
It's the Kitty Cat Search Squad that you should thank.
Oh, Cookie, Candy, and Pudding. Thanks, friends.
Our pleasure.
Oh, what a remarkable job you've done trimming our lawn. Come inside, everyone, and enjoy some freshly baked muffins.
Mommy here. Tea and muffins are on their way. Do you copy? Over.
Yeah, loud and clear.
Now, if anyone needs to find something, the Kitty Cat Search Squad will always be ready to help.
Thank you.